true. I also heard that you love the chef, and I heard that you a business owner too.
How y'all doing? I want to welcome y'all to Strawberry Space, where we discuss transgender relationships.
Kids in Stealth Sharp Shuttles, come in and save the day. It's time to upgrade your plastic bags, woo, and your old jugs, and store your meds in luxury. So sharks, who wants to fill the void of millions of people and take a shot with Stealth Bros & Co.? Let's go!
Yeah.
Yes.
Hey, Strawberry Space. Look, I tricked y'all. I came on that side of the door, didn't I? How y'all doing? I know I haven't shown y'all some face in a long time. I've been so busy with my new job, but I got my handy-dandy notebook. We're here to talk about some transgender-related topics, and we're here to get on to the men, actually, in the African queer community. So we're going to talk about, we got like 6 men on the roster. We're going to talk about Nyko, Lenox Love, King Nyko, Wayne Brady, Dwight Howard, and Braxton Fleming. So we are going to get in touch into it. We want to first congratulate. I feel like I got to bend down. Oh, y'all, I got to fix this camera real quick. Sit down. I'm a little old. I got a little, you know, statue. That 30 is about to hit. Shout out to the 90 babies out there. Okay, so this is the thing. So we're gonna start up with Braxton Fleming. Okay, so he's gonna be the first trans man on Shark Tank. So we're excited about that because, you know, that means so much, you know, for people moving on. And he's really doing a thing by creating a new invention on the trans community. And he's like gonna represent the community in a different way on reality TV. He's not on Zeus. Out now that's TV, not on anything. He's trying to create his own brand to come like real positive. So we want to have a round of applause for that because he's very profound in that. And I just feel like, you know, they were cautious with their words. I'm talking about the judges, by the way, and getting into like him just, I really feel like he gagged them all, if you ask me, to be honest. But I mean, that's good because I feel like passing privilege is real. And had they known it from the jump, it would have been a whole different thing. Don't mind all this, y'all. I was doing my makeup and trying to look to see, like, is the light good? Is the light good? And a little bit got on. I ain't dirty now. All right, so, yeah, and I just feel like as I check him off and go to the next person, it's very, imperative that we notice that this is where, you know, we're going with like this just representation in a nice way, because I feel like so many people are used to us being so messy and our lifestyle just being, you know, just so atrocious and salacious that they could just throw daggers on our community, like, oh, you know what I'm saying, they're not to be trusted, they disrespect women. And then, you know, with trans men, I guess the stereotype would be like, you know, they're just nothing but masculine studs and AGs and doms and dykes and everything. We don't need all that, you know. So hey, cisgender men and women and trans women, I'm back. Y'all like my outfits? Let me get my room out there so y'all can really get into me. Yes. I had, you know, took a lot of time off because I was really getting into some transgender related topics. Y'all know I did activism for Kendra with the Baltimore Brawl, and I did my first protest with shout out to Hope Giselle and Aya Demons. Yes, I did everything, as well as with London the Rich. And we're gonna segue on to our next section because as trans men and women, we're talking about King Nyko. Now, if you don't know King Nyko, he is a TikToker. He's very viral. He just goes on these like little lives where he tries to look at him a little boo. But the only thing I felt like it was on some be fucking for real type shit was, he had put very distinctly in quotations like, hey, I only like women, you know. And I tell y'all, this is the tea girl. I'm gonna give y'all some game. Whenever a man says, I like all women, that's when they include us. When they just say women, that's the very type of, you know, women that they want to attract, that they don't want to offend, because they know if they call a biological woman a cis woman, it's a, you know, it's cut. So I thought it's so weird how he just didn't want another trans woman. I mean, I know we are a handful and some people feel like it's a 0 out of 10 they wouldn't recommend, but it's just kind of like, how are you as a trans man not coming up to a trans woman as your first choice? You're really gonna go back to the society that didn't want you and didn't claim you. Like, that's crazy how, you know, you would just hop back in there, and it's like it's gonna be a chop every time, each and every time. Like, I just want y'all to know that I feel like you want a second chance at being, you know, really want to come back into that. And I just don't know if it's the children aspect of you being the seahorse dad, or it's like the family man of you just willing, like, you want to, you know, step away from the LGBT community. But what is it? Because I just want y'all to know, just food for thought. He's been like really trolling, talking bad about the community, and I felt like I wanted to talk about him because I feel like that's internalized homophobia within, and transphobia within yourself. And everybody in the LGBT community knows that, you know, this is a vulnerable, we're the last letter, literally. And we got the most weight, but it's like we're just in that triple minority sector that just needs to be supported. And it's just like, how can you? But if y'all have ever been on like Twitch, Beagle, or any type of, you know, app, you'll see it's them same women and gay men that, you know, forbid their type of men from us because, you know, I'm a real woman. I got a real pussy and he's a real man and he don't really want you. Go find a gay man. Okay. And we'll go to a bush queen. The bush queen's like, oh no, bitch. I know you averse dicking all these booty holes down. You're not gonna get this asshole. This is mine. We see you as a woman. And anyway, furthermore, we're gay. We like men. So why don't you go over to somewhere else? Okay. I did. A trans man. I'm a trans woman. He's a trans man. Hold on. My light was messing up. This is my man. Like, I own him. Like, are you serious? Like, are you dumb? But, I mean, it's hard, and I know it's his preference, but I just feel like at the same time, you are a greedy bitch. Like, you literally just took over all of this sector of cisgender straight and all of this sector of cisgender gay, and now I can't have the trans. Now you, oh, well, do you like gay boys? No, bitch, you don't. And that phallostatomy and the hysterectomy and all the ectomies and top surgeries he got to make himself like that, you need to line up behind me. I'm the first one in line to suck that dick bookie. Okay, grab a number and get a ticket and stand in line behind me. Because I feel like if you can't claim your man as ownership because, you know, you want to claim them, then I can claim this one. I don't get that strawberry space. Like, I've been seeing that a lot, like, with people just, you know, being cisgender. Like, I accept this man as a man. And it's just like, I want to whisper in their ear, brother, you do know that's the same girl that called me a man. So if that's what she thinks about me, what do you think she thinks about you? Like, it don't make sense. And I just want you to know that, you know, this is a fake allyship. And this is just because you, at the moment she gets mad, you back to being a bitch. You, that dick, that dildo, that shit is back to being plastic in her eyes. And this is just not, you know, it's not for her. I don't get it. I don't get it, and I don't understand how, as a trans man, a trans woman is not your first choice, but I understand that, you know, you have range because you have so many experiences. However, my thing is that you really will give chance after chance more with the biological, because I really do feel like people have had one or two bad experiences with a trans woman, and it's like, I can't do it. Hands up. You know, I'm backing away. But then with a biological woman, you will go through heartbreak after heartbreak after heartbreak and still give that bitch a chance because you want to play daddy, because you want, you know, the White House on the Hill. And, you know what I'm saying? You want to get back into, you know, the bird's eye view of being accepted. But I'm just saying, you cannot force that upon somebody. And I just feel like it will always, forevermore be, you know, just what it is. And I'm telling you the truth. Like, you as a trans man cannot be fetishized. I can't say that word. It's fetishized. And that's really what you're being. All of it's fetishized. I can't say it. So we're gonna mark him off. And I want, and let me tell you something. because a lot of people feel like they don't even know where to meet trans women at. We are, you know, in our communities, that, you know, we're your Walmart cashiers, we're your neighbors, we're your, you know, people who, hey, you know, I'm at the P.O. box, I'm checking my mail at the post office, we're right here with you. But I wanted to bring up Lenox Love because I wanted to tell someone, you know, like, you have options as a trans woman, you know, doing 9-to-5 domestic work and the jobs within the community in the daytime. But you also, if you're feeling, you know, a little bit of discrimination, you can go at nighttime to a strip club. So I'm bringing up Lenox Love. He owns a strip club in Atlanta. Now, in addition to this one with the Tokyo Valentino, it's like Hush Nightlife. They have a Hush in Atlanta and they have a Hush in New York. They have, I think, another transgender strip club in the DMV area in Baltimore. It's called Life Lounge. And then they have, I think, it's another one. I gotta look up the... It's one in LA. I can't think of the name right now. I think it's called Macy Gray's or something. And, you know, you have the options. So I just want to also congratulate Lenox, you know, for giving an opportunity to trans women, for, you know, branching out and having like a, because that's a very gender affirming job, honey. I shake my ass like, yes, like I am over here dancing for these dollars, baby. I'm just like a real woman. And it just gives you a certain type of, you know, zhuzh, you know, as opposed to like, you know, clocking in and out and, you know, doing like, you know, other things that might get you in a situation where, you know, you gotta go to the EEOC, honey. Cause I really feel like, you know, a lot of people look down upon, you know, the escorted community, but it's the same people who, you know, promote the 504 lifestyle that's biological too. So if you could, you would, but you can't. And I just want to also, you know, this is like a sort of, you know, I'm back, so I'm trying to like, you know, rush through this. I'm nervous and everything, but I just wanted to just say, like, you know, I'm very happy that we have these opportunities and options, because for a lot of our elders in the 80s and 70s and 60s, babies, these resources were not available. Like, they had to really, like, you say, blend. They could not disclose. They were harassed very severely. And yeah, I just wanted to really talk about that here. So how do y'all feel about that strawberry space? Do you feel like you would date a stripper, like, if she was trans? Or do you feel like that just would kind of set the community back a little bit? Or do you feel like, you know, there's no way, you know, it could be for you? Because some people couldn't date a stripper, whether she's trans or cis. But I just wanted to kind of bring, you know, some awareness to what was going on, and just I don't know, just shed, you know, some light upon it. And the men that love us, Wayne Brady, okay, he the next one on the list. Where he at? There you go, Wayne Brady, the one that did what's that? The key? He don't do the prices right. What did he do? Let's Make a Deal. He came out as being pansexual, and you know what's crazy is, I'm hurrying up so I can get to the juice part, because I want to really talk about this Dwight Howard situation. Wayne Brady is, you know, pants, and it's like a lot of people feel like when... Here's what I understand. Y'all always say, oh, when someone says, hi, my name is such and such, I'm bisexual, they be like, oh, so you're gay. It's like, no, I didn't say that. But if someone says on the other hand, oh, I'm pansexual, it's like, oh, is that like you're bi? It's like, yeah. Girl, how did y'all do that? Like, how did y'all fuck that up like that? But it's just, you know, it's something that is very rare in our community, seeing, you know, a guy who's comfortable in himself, I'm sitting now, that, you know, is going against all odds, because I bet you there was tons of people who, you know, tried to sexually shame him and tried to really put him in that box and really just deter away from him, like, oh, I'm not gonna date him anymore. We're boycotting all the black pussy in the world, and, you know, we're not gonna be for you. And I just feel like that was just such an awful thing for him, because it's just like, if he wasn't as strong-willed as he is, that could have been the breaking point between, you know, being open-minded and free to being closeted and, you know, down low. I also want to tell this gentleman and woman of this channel, I know it's different when y'all like us and it's very difficult in y'all mind when y'all say, hey, I'm open to trans women, but I've been called a chaser. Now, a chaser is when, honey, you just like all of them. Pokemon, you want to catch them all. And there's some trans women, they feel like, okay, I don't really prefer that. And you might be like, why? I really accept you. And it's just kind of, you know, hard to grasp that someone doesn't really want you in that way. But I'm here to say that some women actually not prefer it, but just prefer the advocacy and the you know, the authenticity, just you standing above everyone and just saying, hey, loud and proud, you know, I am standing with my trans woman. And it's just, for some people, it's kind of like a whoa, you know what I'm saying? Because we have this stigma that, you know, if you're with a trans woman, it's not cool because she's still connecting to the LGBT community. A lot of people feel like, you know, that since we're heterosexual trans women, we shouldn't really be in the LGBT. Me, I am, but I just, I wanted to really shout him out too, because, you know, that was a really brave tactic he did. That was very, noble. And it was also very, because he has the show, it could have been like affect with the ratings. And could have, listen, I started by saying, I knew he was, something was in the water, wasn't clean, when it was this one episode I remember. He was there and he was juggling some pens and he missed one and he went down to get it and his pants had ripped. When it was the rainbow draws, I seen that was, I think my cited source was Instagram because Gay Magazine had posted. I knew from then, I said, oh yeah.
The rainbow. Can you shake the rainbow? I split my pants when I tried to dance. And look at that, cause it's your last chance. Red and green and purple just like Barney. I show my draws, but you wouldn't see Steve Harvey.
The rainbow.
For your Emmy consideration.
Something going on. And I just felt like he wasn't in a safe space to really denounce that. But I'm glad that, you know, he's the show's in Los Angeles, California, is very liberal. And I'm glad that he, you know, got the opportunity to really do that. Unlike Dwight Howard.
Dwight Howard is being sued by a trans woman for forcibly giving them top. Pause. This is the second time there's been an accusation like this against Dwight Howard involving a trans woman. And this time, I guess this person's putting out text messages and all this. The story goes, Dwight was supposed to have a threesome with a dude. Pause. The trans woman showed up. Trans woman didn't want to be there. Dwight threw the person down, forcibly give them top. Pause. God damn, Dwight. What's up with you, man? What's up with you? We keep hearing this. And Dwight also made the news back in the day when he was on the sideline during a game for grabbing his teammates. You know what? I'm lying. Then we got this. This is three. You grabbing teammates' crouches. You out here. These trannies keep bringing your name up and shit, my nigga. But hey, we gonna see. You know, I believe, like, if somebody's been violated, I believe they should go to the law, the police. You know what I'm saying? You're seeing a lot of people who claim to have something done to them just going to go sue somebody instead of going to the law when it happens. So I don't know. I'm just bringing the news. I'm just like.
But if you don't mind that, just for the people who haven't seen the thread, could you read the thread for our audience?
So we're going to skip to the second part of the conversation because that's really what it is. Basically, Dwight said, I want more.
the person who was texting Dwight said, I got you, Poppy. Also, what are you into? You like freaky stuff. Yes, I'm into freaky stuff. Now, I want you to know, I'm not like gay or anything. I'm just a little nasty sometimes. I don't want to offend you. Loved a movie, loved an image, loved an image, loved an image, loved a movie. The person said, yes, and I understand, sexy, we grown. I'm not offended at all. Then it's the slobber emoji, let me see, eggplant emoji. It continues with a lot more emojis, and Dwight is having a time. He said, you have some blank shots, lol. First said, I don't, I can make you some personal ones though. And then Dwight said, I just want to see your eggplant.
Good morning.
Good morning. What do you feel about the whole Dwight Howard and Maxine Elijah? What are your opinions?
I feel it's absolutely disgusting. Like,
I was lying. You would say, you're lying. And you know I'm not lying. Just keep it real. No, oh my God, I literally have been speaking to you for, oh my God, I've been speaking to you for some time now, Dwight. I sent you nudes of me, Dwight. I sent you nudes in general, Dwight. You told me that you wanted to be fucked in your ass, Dwight. You told me that
Not a big old bottom. Now listen, it don't take a rocket scientist to know that, I think... I'm not sure. This is the picture. This is what I'm getting from. I just don't want to cuff right now in Strawberry's face. Or I don't want nothing to like be blocked in this channel. But I feel as though the Masique Elijah, or I don't know if that's her name. I'm calling her with the pronouns just be nice. But I don't know if this is a trans person. But this is just making my thing, because they're saying this was the phone call that was leaked from a trans woman. If you can't tell, you being recorded right now. You, like, come on now, like, keep it stacked. But Dwight, I mean, I thought you loved me, Dwight, but Dwight, I thought you told me not to use the comb, Dwight, but Dwight. Girl, like, what's going on? Then my thing is, I would have never took Dwight for a bottom, like, girl, like, but you know, a lot of people said that they like to get pegged. It was like that also with Phor. I don't know if y'all remember that Strawberry Space. We're going to get into him too. He's another guy who's like into that. And he's straight. He was on Chicago Inquiry. So I'm going to play some of him. But let me get into this too a little bit.
We're gonna get back to that. You have been flirting, Dwight. You knew what I was, Dwight. So what the fuck are you talking about? Am I lying?
I don't remember none of that.
You're lying, you're lying, you're lying. And you know I'm not lying. Just keep it real. No, oh my God. I literally have been speaking to you for, oh my God. I've been speaking to you for some time now.
And then this is my thing. Hold up. I gotta keep pressing my mic because the timer going off. That was the first instant. That was like in 2018, 2019. Girl, let me tell you the tea. Now it's this new thing where he was on this man or whatever. So he was on this man, and the man had pressed charges against him because he said he was forcing himself upon it. They talked about it on The Breakfast Club. Now, this is the shade. They talked about it on The Breakfast Club with Charlamagne and DJ Envy, but then he went on the other podcast with the girl who left The Breakfast Club and got replaced with Jess Hilarious. Angela Yee went on the way up. So he had went over there to speak his piece, and he was trying to convince, you know, him and the other girl, all this and that, like as if, but it's just like, okay, but you overseas doing it. Like, you never denied it and said it wasn't true. So it's kind of like, where's all this coming from? Ooh, I'm hot, Strawberry. This is some good shit. Then on top of that, it was another girl. Now, this is the one really where I wanted this to come over here. Her name is Miss Kitty. Miss Kitty was the one that they had wanted a threesome with. And when they wanted to have them come into the bedroom, he had texted him. And those were the texts that they were reading on The Breakfast Club that was sent from Dwight's phone over to the other boy to... you know, get all in the trunk with that. And when he said no, that's when Dwight couldn't take it. But my thing is, why call Miss Kitty as a third party if that's what you really want? It's obvious that you don't want a man. You want some a little extra. So why just get a little extra? Since you're in space, that's my thing. You don't worry about your career, what your friends would think, but I'm just saying, after the basketball, after all this and that, that's your personal time. Maybe if you wasn't so worried about hiding who you was, the leak wouldn't have been, you know, so spontaneous out the door. Because listen, we know that if we leak something with like Bobby Valentino or Tyga or Chris Brown, child, ain't nobody like gonna care because we used to seeing it. But with you, it's just such a big story because you denying and ducking and dodging like Lil' Kim trying to just get everything out the way. And instead of just being a man and standing on 10, like you like sucking dick, you like getting fucked, you like what you like swallowing cum, spitters of quitters. And I mean, you like bend it over as well as throwing a ball and alley-ooping and rebounding. It's nothing wrong with that. It's okay. I'm pretty sure that doesn't affect your performance. But I'm just saying, if it did, you need to provide sis with a little more hushman. We still don't know what Miss Kitty looked like. I'm going to put the link of the picture right here. This is my other phone, child. So I just feel like in all, the biggest thing that I was worried about from this was the fact that he was denying it. He's denying and lying and doing all this thing. And I just want the cisgender men and women of this channel to know that sometimes, you know, I know y'all watch this as allies, but as for, you know, connection with the trans community, you have to be real with your homegirls at this time and say, listen, sis, you know, we need to have free reign with these men and allow them to really be themselves, because the reason he's not being forthcoming is, we don't want to say it, but it is because of, you know, us, you know, the black community, biological women that, you know, don't allow him to have a safe space to even express this. You know what I'm saying? There was a guy who just proposed to his wife, and he just told her, like, oh, you know, hey, I know we're in our 30s or 40s now. I've been back in the college. I slept with a couple guys. It is what it is. And, you know, from all that honesty that he gave and transparency, she canceled the wedding. And it's very unfortunate that it happened, but it's just kind of like, that's why some people really lie, because they feel like, hey, you can't handle the truth. Trust me, believe me, I'm a Scorpio. I know. I've been the sneaking, the geeking, the freaking, the lying, and everything, because I feel like it will protect you or benefit me. But it's just the fact that you doing this knowing that it's so much of an epidemic. They'll sit right here. The news will come over, the trans woman dying, and they'll just lay like right at you. Like, they'll give a fuck knowing that it's probably their homeboy that did it. It's all in community, and it's just intertwining, because, you know, the scapegoat is this woman. This is his beard. He's hiding behind you. He's hiding behind your kids. And he's hiding behind anything that might give probable cause to his defense. I'm like, he's not gay. You know what I'm saying? He's been married for how many? He's not gay. You know what I'm saying? He coaches, you know, the young men's football league. He's not gay. He volunteers with this and that. And he's not a child. It's too much going on with that, and I just feel like, you know, it's a lose-lose situation on the trans side, because it feels like, you know, you're just trying to advocate for the women and just spread awareness, but then sometimes it comes off as you low-key trying to convince someone or something, and then at the same time they can gaslight you and say, well, if you're a trans woman, you're trying to transition to a woman, why, what would they need for you to say this? Like, I'm not, you know, trying to, I thought I was helping my sister out, then I'm just, you know, trying to, listen, you're not gonna have me sign no NDA. Let me stand up on that. I'm getting a little passionate on that, bitch. Fuck that. If I fucked you and your dick was in my mouth, I should be able to, with that same mouth I sucked it with, speak and say who I did what with. You're not gonna tell me what I can't say, what I can't do, and where I can't go, and who I can't say nothing to, because my thing is, biological women do it too. And the fact that you would have me say that just to express my feelings and show you some receipts and to cover it up like I'm exposing, you are really low. And the fact that you do all of that just to prove your point, to gaslight that our community is not to be fucked or trust with, is crazy. And you know, I'm just, I have to really look at Phor. Like I said, I was going to come back to him. This is just a cross-reference real quick. I love the authenticity and I love the transparency. He's on X, you know, formerly known as Twitter, really speaking his piece. He was also with Angela Lee, but on another show with Lip Service, and really saying, you know, like how he, now child, he had this one little Twitter thing where he had his number out and then everything. I'll post some pictures with some emojis, ass out with the, you know, pantyhose, and he role plays. And I mean, she was going to town, but it was just like, anything but a trans woman. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's literally the same thing, whether we got titties in and the dick is plastic and the dick is real. It's still penetration. But I can at least own and have more respect for Phor as a opposed to Dwight. This is a black thing today, okay? So if you don't want to see the black man combo today, this is just what it is. Because as a man prior, I know how it is. Strawberry Space, I didn't been in certain situations because I was dealing with women, and I still deal with women a little bit, you know, on the side, where I was 16 asking a girl, you know, can I take you out? Shit. Do you live alone? Do you work? Do you drive? Bitch, you know I don't work and drive. We ride the same bus. We work at the same job, and we live in the same place with our mamas. And we 16. Why I gotta have more than you to, you know, date you? I understand the plight. I understand your struggle, and I understand where you're coming from, because it feels like you can't do nothing. You can't eat a banana. You can't smoke a hookah. You can't even, back in the day, I remember the 2000s, it was left is right, right is wrong. If you get a piercing on the right ear, you're automatically fruity. But it's just like, you know, it's just certain things along with the sassy and zestiness that, you know, you have to own. And they say, hey, you know, I'm comfortable with my masculinity and this is who I am. If you don't like it, hit the dough. Because I'm not finna entertain somebody 24/7 that I'm fucking with and I have to kind of, you know, give a persona of toxic masculinity just to make you feel comfortable to act like you the woman, you could do all this and the third, and I can't do anything. You know, I deserve a life too. If I want a little blonde streak in my hair, I'm gonna get it. If I want a mohawk, I'm gonna get it. If I want some tight pants, you know, if I want to, you know what I'm saying, put some Carmex on my lips, you know what I'm saying, moisturize, have a skincare routine, have a massage, facials, whatever, I should be able to do it. And you should be my woman standing right here next to me, cheering me on, promoting this self-care as if nothing is wrong. And I don't think there's nothing wrong with that. He mentioned with the trans woman on the podcast show. Let me see if I can find it. Let me see if I can look it up. Because at first I was like, that's just like dating a trans woman. He was like, oh, well, I just want this and that. And I said, child, he'll never admit to date with a girl. He later on, okay, there you go. It's long, by the way.
What about trans women?
So I had an experience with
him right here.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
I don't think I see
it. It was with a girl I was dealing with.
He's cute.
And she was married. Mm-hmm. And she got up with me for her fetishes. You know
okay.
What I'm and you know, she was into like the pegging and all that type of stuff, right?
Did her husband know?
No,
of course not, girl.
And my thing is, like I said, pegging and trans woman, but like I said, because it's not an actual trans woman, the hate ain't the same. Y'all didn't think about that because, oh, we could just let it fly. But really, if you want to be technical and have the same, you know, type of this delta, and y'all close minded. Y'all too, oh, I can't do
that. She said she got with me to fulfill her.
Yeah, because she couldn't do none of that at home.
None of that went at home, so she, that but, was her escape.
Yeah, but the thing was, like I said, like, we had a, we had one day she wanted to have a threesome, right? She didn't say who or anything like that. We went to the hotel, you know what I mean? She hit the lights real low. Now, manager, this probably been rocking with her for a minute, so we already kind of comfortable. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So
now hit the lights real low. I'm sorry.
I know what she into. She know what I'm into type shit. But when she brought her partner, the girl, or whatever, because of who I was, she had the lights dim anyway. Mm-hmm. Because she didn't want the girl to be like,
oh my God, that's fun.
Yeah, yeah. She just wanted her to get lost in the moment.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So they started making out. You know what I'm saying?
Dick a heart.
No,
See, and that's what I'm saying. And y'all will sit up and kiki with them same people. I know y'all just heard that. And my thing is, Strawberry Space, first of all, I'm just applauding the whole storyline and plot. We're not going to use this as further like exposure, trying to like, because I don't even know if Caesar's still fool around with him and Duchess and all that. I don't even know if he's still on the show. But my thing is, you know,
making out. Sorry. This is a while ago too, though. But look, they was making out or whatever. I was blindfolded at first, and then she took him off, and so I'm sitting there. They making out. I'm like, okay, it's busting, it's popping. You know what I'm saying? And I imagine light's still up. So you know, I get to doing my thing or whatever. She's this is when I knew it was a trans woman. So short, the girl I was with, she had a little strap on stuff, and then next thing you know, I'm watching her get penetrated by the other woman.
But a trans?
With no strap.
So it was a trans that didn't have the surgery.
First of all, it's not a trans, it's trans.
Yeah, she was fucking. Like, she was talking about this, she was getting fucked. So at that point, I'm like, oh, wow. So after we got done everything, I told her, like, man, I wish you would have told me. Like, you know.
I need a little heads up.
Just so it's more comfortable, like, just so we know what we're getting into. But I wasn't mad at her, you know what I'm saying? Because
now, he had to mention that now. He had to mention there was no disclosure because of the stereotype. That's the only thing I did like about that right there. But I'm pretty sure that, you know what I'm saying, like, come on now. You know what I'm saying? And then to be honest with you, already dealing with a woman with a strap, it's not too far-fetched or far off. So we not finna sit up here and act like as if, you know, it was that much of a problem. But I do feel like, you know, disclosure is very important, and it is something that, you know, you shouldn't play around with or withhold from somebody, especially during sex. I don't know why bitches in my community. Now listen, I'm gonna say something trans women and men on this channel. Y'all can't be waiting till the last minute when shit happen, and they want someone to advocate for you and share y'all posts and the picture and hashtag say my name when it's like, bitch, Now some of these niggas do be lying, but some of y'all bitches just be wanting that dick so motherfucking bad and to get a coin that y'all will
It just made me a little more open-minded. Like, I started like kind of started like, cause Shorty was very, I ain't gonna lie, like, people do they have so much great surgery out here. I'm like, wow, like, you know? Yeah. And she was really a pretty girl, like, not really a lot of makeup and none of that stuff. So I really didn't know at the moment, but once I learned about it, I started seeing, like, okay, that's how they look now. So I started paying attention more, and now I've been kind of bringing more awareness to them, because I feel like they don't get enough recognition, or people feel like they don't need to be talked about, and act like they don't exist.
Right.
You know, so I do speak on them. Yeah, did it.
They
like,
you don't gotta
sneak
around.
Yeah, but like, I know a lot.
Now, don't say that and come back in the next breath, and then when somebody does that, you want to deal with it. See, my secret vendetta against people is they never let people be themselves, and they feel like they have to cap and hide and live a lie. When they go into a job interview, they have to put on a front. When they go on a first date, they have to put on a front. When they go around their parents, they have to put on a front. Be who you are isn't just that singing expression on TikTok. That's really like words to really live by, to showcase your life. Because if you can't be who you are, how do you expect to meet your soulmate if your soulmate is going to be attracted to who you are? But they're attracted to you, but you act not like you. And like I said, it's just, I'm gonna try to just, you know, pay it with the female comments of what they're saying, but it's not that easy. And the fact that they're trying to make it that easy is really sending me. But the whole thing I'm just trying to say is, we're not gonna sit up here and act like you've given a safe space for black men to really explore their sexuality to trans women. You barely want to give them the space to explore to white women. So I'm conscious enough. That was a nice try.
I can go on a trans woman's page right now, and I see one of my friends like their pictures, but I would never point them out. But I see, like, oh, I'm at, oh, okay.
Yeah.
But publicly, they probably never say that. Yeah. But the thing is, it's like, well, you ain't gonna find this page unless you into that. Like, you know what I'm saying? You gotta, yeah. You know what I mean? You know how the algorithm works and stuff. So, but like I said, I just
bring this bitch acting all on. Right.
Like, at the end of the day, like they may be some, that's somebody's family member. You know what I'm saying?
So would you be attractive to a trans?
I mean, woman? I feel like they if your goal, this is why I feel like the, if your goal is to look as much as a woman as you want to be, then it's like, of course, you're supposed to look attractive if I'm attracted to women.
He said she was beautiful.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Right. No make, very little make.
And that bitch that asked that question was messy as fuck because she wanted the answer to be a no because, well, no, I can't get over the fact that it was born men, but it was still a good sex session. But he gagged them by saying, no, I would. And that's what I really love and respect for him for that because I felt like, you know, he really isn't trying. I mean, he's, but that becomes with maturity because he's now at a point in time where, you know, acceptance of people pleasing is beneath him and that because he's in his 30s. Now, if he was in his 20s, you know, still dibbling dabbling, still wanting to be, you know, most popular out here in these streets, that'd be a different thing. But my thing is, you know, it's just so sad it takes, all of that, you know, just to get, some clarity, some recognition, some acceptance, and some really just some, you, I don't want to say support, but emotional support, because I don't want y'all to confuse emotional support with sex, but I'm just saying that that's truly what it is. So, yeah.
So they trying to cancel Neo. He went on a podcast and he was asked a question about some LGBTGE electric shit where he responded and said, I'm gonna read this shit. If your little boy comes to you and says, Daddy, I want to be a girl, and you just let him rock with that, he's five. If you let this five-year-old boy decide to eat candy all day, he gonna do that. When did it become a good idea to let a five-year-old, let a six-year-old, let a 12-year-old make life-changing decisions for themselves? He went on to say, I just personally come from an era where a man was a man and a woman was a woman. The singer stated, and there was two genders, and this is how I rocked. You could identify as a goldfish if you feel like, I don't care. That ain't my business. It becomes my business when you try to make me play the game with you. I'm not gonna call you a goldfish, but if you wanna be a goldfish, go be a goldfish. We live in weird times, man. We do. So let me show you how both sides is wrong. The people who agree with Neo and the motherfucking LGBT blah. So boom, gender, bro. Gender is something we came up with. It's the word, man or woman. That's just a word used to recognize something. You can recognize something as whatever the fuck you want. As long as we know what we talking about, that's all that motherfucking matter. If I could call gas water, and I could call fire beer. Put water and beer together then. I don't give a fuck what you call it. I want to make sure you safe. Put it together, fam, and you're not going to make it. Yo said it's only two genders. Gender is just something that we've used to recognize something that we observe in society or the world, right? See, we as a collective haven't fucked around and found out yet that the labels we give things are not the things themselves. What the thing can still be perceived and understood even in silence without you saying anything. The language is just a conspiracy that we have amongst each other to both say, hey, I see that red ball. Do you see that? Are you feeling what I'm feeling in here? You getting that? You getting that light from that? You processing the same red light that I see as a red ball? You see that? He say, yeah, but he called a ball a square. It's gonna be difficult for him, but y'all see the same thing. This whole conversation about man or woman, bro, listen, for me, none of that shit matters because as long as a person is conscious, be conscious because life doesn't give a fuck about what you label it and how you come to understand it. Life cares only if you understand what's really going on. If you know gasoline, you ain't gotta call it gasoline. You don't gotta call it fire. But if you should be quiet and you look at some gas and some fire, even if you put that shit together inside, silence without saying anything, it's going to explode because life never gave a fuck about what you call it. Well, you could say this is water now, and this is a leaf now. Put that water and that leaf together. You're out of this bitch. See, both sides of this situation have come to identify themselves as this motherfucking body. You don't know neither one of these people know themselves farther than they five senses. Neo identifies, I'm a man, and a man is this. And the LGBT, I'm the sex, I'm the gender, I'm a woman. You're identifying with your sex, religion, race, caste, creed, money, status, the identities of the human race are broken up so fucking bad. That is why it's so much division. There is no one's identity collectively has yet to be unified with everything. That's why it's so many problems. It's not the fault of the world that motherfuckers is off in theyself because life ain't going the way they want it. It's not the fault of the world that LGBTQ people is offing themselves because that person over there won't call you a woman and that person over there don't feel like how you feel. The problem here is that all parties involved only know themselves no further than their five senses. His identity is with his fucking his brown skin color, and his identity is with what's between his fucking legs and the clothes he wear and shit like that. Neither one of them realize you are of the same substance. There's only one substance that exists that gives life to all things. There is no separation between nothing. That science is disproving that. There is no fucking my life and your life. Your identity is one with the motherfucker that you looking at. What you are on the most profound level, beyond your five senses, beyond your flesh, bone, thoughts, and imagination. Everything that you think you are and that you have come to think of yourself to be, that you perceive with your five senses, is just a reflection off of a fragment of the infinite. So the problem here is the ignorance, the lack of understanding of what I'm saying. If you teaching your kids to answer the question of what am I or who am I, with anything perceived by the five senses, you setting them up anyway. Because if the world don't support that identity, which because there's always gonna be people that won't, either the whole world will shift to accommodate their inability to live, or they're gonna come up out this bitch because they can't stand on their own understanding of themselves, because you fucked that up. All on this side, telling them that, no, your identity is insert material, some aspect of material creation. And the motherfuckers over here on the LGBT or the other side is, no, you, your identity can be insert some aspect of material creation, but you get to pick it though. When you understand that you are not the material body, material creation, or the mind, then that understanding of knowing I don't know who the fuck I am can flourish without being attached to this fucking world, aka ignorance. So y'all's solution is make sure kids know that there's a man and there's a woman and that's it. Du-du-du-du-du. That's wrong. That's not gonna help them. Or y'all's solution is make sure kids know that you can identify as anything you want. Like it don't work like that. That's wrong either, because you want the babies to be conscious. Because if they're conscious, they'll always know that they are not of this material creation. So now their curiosity turns to this in here, and they begin to wonder and pay attention to this better than any of y'all pay attention to anything, because kids pay attention. That's the nature of us. They'll go in here for those answers and pay attention and learn how to use this body damn probably better than you. Without their identity being tied to finite shit, they can always move through life fully able to consciously conduct this system internally how they want. They don't need you. If they want now, if they want to be joyful, they can be joyful. And if they want to, from that point of joy, go do something out in the world to express that joy, then it doesn't matter what you do or say. That's not even going to determine how they treat you or whether they do it or not. They'll grow to then understand that the source of their experience, their joy, their anger, their happiness, their sadness, their depression, their madness is coming from in here. And with more attention being paid to this, they'll learn how to use it better. And now they don't need to do things to feel great. They'll know how to feel great and do things from feeling great. If he dresses like a woman, but he's a male, he won't be dressing like a woman to feel good. He'll be dressing like a woman because he feels good. And it won't matter if he can or can't dress like a woman, or if he is or isn't allowed to. It won't even matter, because his source of his joy won't come from the outside in. He'll have been learned how to live his life from the inside out. So all this back and forth about kids is hurting themselves because y'all confusing them about gender, it's just a man and a woman. Or kids is hurting themselves because y'all won't affirm their pronouns and shit like that. All of that's not right. These kids is hurting themselves because y'all ain't teaching them how to live. Because in the simplest terms, any consequences or problems that we see on both sides of any argument, of any division in the world today, comes from one thing. And that one thing is that for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years in the world, we have been teaching the next generation by how we live that in order to experience anything within yourself, joy, anger, sadness, happiness, bliss, whatever the fuck, in order for anything to happen happen in here, something must happen out here. So rather than their life be an expression of how they conduct themselves within, they are doing things in life so that they can conduct themselves within, because they don't know how to do it on their own. Because their parents didn't, and their grandparents didn't, and the ones before them is the blind leading the blind. So rather than go out in the world and get money because you're joyful and you want to do things in the world and you just recognize money is something you're gonna have to get, you go get money because you need it in order to be joyful. They're not selling clothes because they happy. They selling clothes to be happy. They're not going under surgeries because they're happy. They're going under surgeries to be happy. They're not getting in relationships because they're happy. They're getting in relationships to be happy. They're not changing laws because they're happy. They're trying to change laws so that they can be happy. And the ignorance of this is what's given life to all the causes of the prejudices, division, hate, violence, all of it. So for the majority of the world, you think that you're something that you are not, and the rest of life is paying the price for it. Because of your inability to use this system properly to your benefit, you create feelings / experiences within yourself that are unpleasant to you. And because you don't know that you're doing that, you blame that on the world around you. So you strive to organize the world around you in a way that can make you feel good, never to know that that is a futile effort. It'll never happen, because life is ever changing and it'll never go the way you want it all the time. So until you consciously lift your identity above that which is perceived by the five senses that we know as creation and your body and all this, you'll always be limited by self-imposed boundaries, forever to be against someone and fight someone instead of the ignorance instead. And until further notice, you'll forever be a part of the...
So our brother Neo said some things that got him quoted in the Fox News, and I think that it's a great teachable moment.
I ain't asked nobody to agree with me. I was asked a question, and I answered the damn question, okay? I have no beef with the LGBTQIA+ community whatsoever. I ain't got no beef with y'all. Do whatever the hell it is you want to do. Do what you want to do with your kids. However, somebody asked my opinion on this matter, and this is how I feel. I will never be okay with allowing a child to make a decision that detrimental to their life. I will never be okay with that. I don't care. I definitely plan to educate myself a little bit more on this matter. I doubt that there's any book anywhere or any opinion that somebody's going to tell me that's going to make me okay with letting a child make a decision like that. That's just period, point blank, and that's how I feel. If I get canceled for this, then you know what? Maybe this is a world where they don't need a Neo no more, all right? And I got no problem with that. I'm a hustler, all right? I'll figure it out. I got kids to raise, and I'm going to do that regardless. So with that being said...
So as a father and a fellow black man, in the name of education, let's turn this to a teachable moment. Some of you might be asking yourself, but what did he actually say that's caused this backlash? Let's get into it. Neo was on a podcast where he was asked the question, and here's how he responded. I feel like parents have almost forgotten what is the role of a parent is. Your little boy comes out to you and says, Daddy, I want to be a girl. And you just let him rock with that? He's five. You let a five-year-old decide to eat candy all day, he gonna do that. When did it become a good idea? When did it become a good idea to let a five-year-old, let a six-year-old, let a 12-year-old make life-changing decisions for themselves? Neo continued by saying, I just personally come from an era where a man was a man and a woman was a woman. And there was two genders. That's just how I rocked. You can identify as a goldfish if you feel like it. I don't care. That ain't my business. It becomes my business when you try to make me play the game with you. I'm not going to call you a goldfish. But if you want to be a goldfish, you got to be a goldfish. We living in a weird time. I'm going to start by saying this. 1 in 4 black trans youth has attempted to unalive themselves in the past year based off the climate and the rhetoric that we give for how exposable, disposable, and non-human like we view people that are trans. This next part is very important right here. No 4-year-olds, 5-year-olds, or 12-year-olds is taking gender hormones or receiving surgeries. Research over me search, the World Professional Association for Transgender Health says that hormones could be started at the age of 14, 2 years earlier than the group's previous advice, and some surgeries done at the age of 15 or 17, a year or earlier so than previous guidance. Which means the idea of 5-year-olds or 6-year-olds or even 12-year-olds being able to make life-altering decisions is empirically false. You see what I'm saying? It's used as a false narrative to really create paranoia and hysteria around individuals that identify as trans. Now, I know I might have said some things you probably disagree with, but I showed you the research and the studies that backs it, right? The next thing is, I'm sure we all agree on preserving black life, especially black kids' lives. Listen, according to a study by the Trevor Project, a quarter of black transgender and non-binary youth reported to unalive themselves attempt the previous year. That's more than twice the rate of unalived attempts reported by black LGBTQ people who are not trans. transgender or not binary, which means the way that we talk about transgender people, the way the climate is positioning for transgender people, leads to studies like this.
Or should I say the findings in studies like this?
Now, Neo is from an era where men were men and women were women, but Neo was born in 1979. And the Stonewall riots happened in 1969, 10 years before he was born. And the Stonewall riots was kicked off because this black transgender woman, 10 years before he was born, started to fight back against police brutality and it literally jumped off the entire pride movement. Peep game, Marsha P. Johnson was born in 1945. Which means, even back in your era and before you were born, Neo, this was already going on. Individuals identifying with genders that were not assigned at birth. This part right here important. I know you weren't trying to offend nobody, you see what I'm saying? I know a lot of individuals talk about the LGBTQIA plus community and be like, I ain't trying to offend nobody, I ain't trying to offend nobody. But then you will compare their identity to a goldfish or to eating candy. Very trivial and pathological, right? See how people in that community feel some type of way? You know, education is elevation. A lot of us don't recognize that we are lost in the sauce and the way that colonialism was, you know, polluted our ways of understanding gender. The deviant African genders that colonialism demonized or condemned. European travelers and anthropologists found that their gendered worldview didn't easily map onto the societies they encountered. With that being said, when you look up trans identities in ancient Africa, because, you know, ain't nothing new under the sun. Traditionally, the Ugandan peoples were largely accepting of trans and gay people. The Lango peoples accepted trans women. Male assigned people called Joapu, I'm sorry I'm saying it wrong because I'm country, or Joaboch, who were believed to have been transformed in the conception into women by the androgynous deity Jock. I just want to sprinkle some historical context because a lot of times we view the trans identity or trans community as uniquely being like a modern day invention. It's just like, nah, that's not true. I think a lot of times we view children as being kind of ignorant to how gender operates, but we know that study shows that taken together that these studies suggest that most children develop their ability to label gender groups and use gender labels in their speeds between 18 and 24 months. As opposed, the self-socialization theories recognize that this came from how we get kids to play with strongly stereotyped toys around gender. Let me get a little philosophical with you. In college, I learned this word called epistemology. It's a fancy word for knowledge production, and how I understand it is like, how do you know what you know and where do you get what you know? For instance, if you believe Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue in 1492, that's a particular epistemological understanding. If you believe that boys were blue and girls were pink, that is a particular epistemological understanding. Epistemology is defined as the theory of knowledge, especially in regard with methods, validity, and scope. Epistemology is the investigation of what distinguishes, justifies beliefs from opinion. What is your epistemological understandings of gender? Where did you learn gender? How did you come to understand gender? Where did your notions of gender come from? These are all epistemological questions that surround gender. I say this respectfully, but a lot of us have an epistemology of ignorance when it comes to our understandings of gender. I know some folks gonna be mad about this, but gender affirming care can be the matter of life and death. With that being said, in 2023, from the East Coast to the West Coast, we see many states pass legislation against gender-affirming care and against trans youth being able to really do anything. And we know when it comes to people that look like us, I don't care what your identity is, when it comes to people that look like us, we know that we're going to get the bottom of the barrel of the impacts. You see what I'm saying? And we know that black people, we exist everywhere in all communities. In conclusion, I got two kids as well, a 5-year-old and a 7-year-old. They come to me and say, hey, pops, the way I was assigned gender at birth is not the way I feel. You see what I'm saying? I'm gonna start dealing with it. But peep game though, you see, legally, I cannot give my 5 and my 7-year-old any type of hormones. You see what I'm saying? They can't conduct any type of surgeries. There is intentional misinformation surrounding this topic about transness and trans identities. If some of us ain't free, then none of us ain't free, and this applies to black trans people, especially black trans youth. Education is elevation. I'm Burke.
One thing I can't stand is a sassy banana. Back in your day, men used to be men and women used to be women. I ain't never see a man do some shit like this. I don't even got a picture this sassy. The only reason Neo really throwing shade is because he one of the baddest bitches to ever do it. He want to go back to living that femme queen life. And the fact that he wrote Irreplaceable is just a little too questionable. Don't get me wrong, my brothers be snapping on songs for the girls, but Irreplaceable hit a little too hard. look at Nyko when his crop top bust down, showing the boys a little extra meat.
Nyko was a bad bitch. If this ain't butch queen realness, I don't know what is.
But eventually, Nyko had to hang his bad bitch boots up because he was getting a little up. But he always kept a little sassy ass hat with him. As a child, I always wondered, what the fuck was under that hat? It was a nightmare. Ain't no way Forehead made take a bow.
Bitch, I just had to pick myself up off the floor after reading this.
Are we not scared? Is anybody not clutching their motherfucking pearls? How did this man write Pretty Girl Rock?
I literally remember the exact conversation me and my mama had when she told me Nyko made his first wife tie her tubes because he didn't want no more kids, but then he went out and got another bitch pregnant.
I knew then these niggas wasn't dead.
Confucius, I just got one message for you.
That was real gay, my nigga. Cut that out.
Wait, that was the wrong clip.
Stay out of gay folks, bitch.
Okay, so, here's my thing with the whole Nyko situation, because I look at it from two different aspects, because I transitioned at 19. I wanted to transition earlier, but I felt like I was obeying my family because it's like my house, my rules. So I was kind of like, okay, let me do it where I'm in high school, so that way I can do what I want to do. Even though that is kind of early, but then they still saw it as being sneaky, so you can't really please people anyway. And then I see it from the parents' point of view of, hey, you know, they're gonna take my, because when he said this thing about the taking the child away, that hit very close home to me. Like that kind of, you know, it wasn't really fair to say, I feel like, in my point of view, for a guardian standpoint. As I get a little older, I'm 29, so, you know, it just would make me feel a type of way if, okay, you don't even know, you know, what you want for breakfast, you know what I'm saying? But you over here saying, like, you want to transition, how do you know you're sure? My mother always told me, how do you know you want to be a woman if you've never been one before? I said, well, there's got to be something better than this. And I meant it. But I mean, now it's just overshadowing simple homosexuality. Like, you know, you can't have a gay boy just be flamboyant and have tight clothes. We have to ask, like, are you beginning to transition? You know, because it's just so common. It's not like I'm happy it's forced. But it's just like, I'm just happy, like, we're just seeing it so periodically that no one's like, it's no shock factor anymore, if that makes sense. So, like, I understand what he's saying. I definitely do feel like he should have been read, because that was just too much. You got all these kids and you know what I'm saying? Don't act like you're so concerned now for their life just because, first of all, you wasn't so concerned like to marry their mother and make a full family, because that is a broken home if you're having all these baby mamas. But now that they're here and you're taking care of your kids, because, you know, black people always feel like I can have a million kids everywhere, but if I pay child support, that's taking care of them. But, you know, I did hear his argument. I was trying not to listen to be offended. I was trying to listen to educate. I do feel as though, you know, from a parent standpoint, because there are times, I'm not gonna lie, trans men and women on this channel, that I do think about my father, you know, like, if he worries about me, if he wonders, you know, just because he doesn't accept me, you know, he, like, it does not mean he doesn't love me. And, you know, the fact that I blocked him, he doesn't know where I am, what I'm doing, and how my well-being is, it does affect me, because if I become to, like, adopt a children or foster care, you know, I wouldn't want my kids to feel like they couldn't come to me with any safety. But I mean, it's just, you know, it's hard because, you know, acceptance goes, and then you don't want it to trickle over into being spoiled to the point where it's like, I'm not gonna give you away, but however I treat you in the test of time will determine, you know, how you feel. Because I feel like, you know, a parent can give their child anything I want and they still won't come back. You know what I'm saying? So it also it's on the child and the parent. In this situation with him being the parent, I feel like, okay, you, like I said, one thing, you're gay. So that's the best, number one, we're going to start. to, I don't even know how they got on that conversation. Three, the whole thing that, you know, I really want to just say, because I've heard a lot of gay people who, before they transition, say, I wouldn't want my child to be gay. I wouldn't mind my child being trans. We just have to take extra precautions to protect them from the world. There are some gender affirming care decisions that, if you made too quick, it's like a regret. I sometimes regret not saving my sperm, even though I'm castrated and I did it. So I definitely can relate. I definitely feel like you should be 18. Do I feel like 16 is too young? See, that's my thing. It's like, okay, you can't transition when you under 18, but you can be pregnant, you can have the tattoos, you can go to DJJ, you could drink, you could cut class, you can do any of the things but it's just like, I just consider that just as anything. And I just feel like, even though a lot of those things aren't, but some of the things aren't reversible, though. I know some people feel like, okay, that's nothing, but no, so you getting pregnant in 16, that's irreversible. You going to jail in 16, that stays on your record. And even though you can get it expunged and all case dismissed, some life experiences are meant to have, and I would consider being trans as anything else. I mean, maybe that's just me. Like, okay, if I'm a parent and you want to transition and then you change your mind, okay. You know, what did you learn? Why do you want to transition and now you don't want to transition? Or why you want to detransition? Okay, why you want to detransition? I'm just like, okay, listen, it's your life. I can't do everything for you. And I can't, you know, protect you from everything and shelter and self-sabotage. You know, just your character, who you are, because I'd rather you experience it with me than someone else. I do feel, like I say, I'm here with him. I'm not being unempathetic to what he's saying, and I'm not desensitized because I've heard these conversations before. What I'm saying is, what the part that threw me for a loop is when he mentions, like, okay, now you try to get me to see it. But I just always tell people, like I said with the Candace Owens thing, okay, if we try to do it, why are you acting like you've never done it? If you know I have a penis and you call me a she and you say, but now you want me to accept it, like that's what has gone too far, you already accepted it. You didn't call me a man. You called me what I wanted to be called. You called me the pronouns I wanted. You've given me everything at face value that I wanted. Even if you fake it, talk about Muhammad back, you already did what I've asked you to do. So at what point do you not accept what I can? Especially if you didn't know me back in the day. Like, if you just meet me now before, I'm like, hell no. Hey, I'm a man. Like, no. Like, bitch, who does that? So I'm just like, you know, I would have to further my investigation on, you know, what his take on this is, because I really do feel like he's at a place where he, like I said, he is concerned. I don't feel like it was, he had his apology, child, which I feel like was BS. But I just feel like in this moment, yes, it does scare people and there's so much that you can and can't say, but I feel like you've said enough to the point where now that we're gonna cancel you, it's really in our defense, because like I said, if there wasn't anything to protect us, you would have kept going and going and going. That lady was so crazy, just like egging him on. She was the biggest pick me. I do feel like I said, tomboy has been confused now for trans man, and just, you know, the twink has been confused for the new trans woman. So there is like a little blurred lines between I'm transitioning because I feel this way and I'm just, you know, gay and I like to do certain things. I like to be who I am. You know, I really do feel for him because he's in a point where, you know, it's like, it's family ethics and morals, it's boundaries, there's certain amount of things that, you know, he has to deal with and accept, especially since he's from the old school. I really think the pussy kind of got into him because of that money. And if he was broke, I really feel like he would be down the, you know, same community as us. But, you know, I just feel like, you know, I'm really torn between this feeling, because it's really like, it's really given, like, okay, you're a good father, you're aware, you're just, you know, a little scared and concerned. I could feel that coming from him. You definitely have to be open-minded and willing to learn, but it's just certain things that, I really won't be able to answer until I'm truly a parent, Strawberry Space, but I just feel like, you know, we're not gonna sit up here and act like as if when we were 16, like, we were angels as well. So, like I said, I mean, I would have to then again just get some more dialogue with that, like, hey, you know, but I mean, hey, if we're just being grateful, I'm glad you apologized, whether it was for a PR from your publicist or whether it was a real apology. I'm glad you understand that you have a lot of trans, I'm sure, fans and a lot of people that you affected by your conversation. I'm glad you're conscious and woke to everything that's happening. I'm apologizing. I'm sorry that, you know, you have that fear of, you know, your custody being revoked because you're not letting people do what they want to do. And listen, if you think all that in California, you can surely move to Florida, okay? Because, I mean, they really, there's a lot of DeSantis. I'm sure y'all share the same values, but it's just, like, really, isn't it sad that it's like, damn, like, I remember So Sick of Love songs. I remember Miss Independent, and it's like the very person that I love and support with my time, with my money, with my memories, can't support me. And it goes there because it's just like, you know, you really don't see it for me. And I don't feel like you see it for my community either at any age. I just think you're just hiding behind the alibi of the age, like, oh, 16 18, now it's gonna be 21 25, you know, is what they're trying to bend in Texas. So, like, is it about the children? Is it really about the children? Because I don't think so. I really don't. I mean, I could be wrong, you know, like I'm saying, but I'm just, how I feel about the situation is you're just putting a lot of emphasis on this. And I feel like you're trying to fish out for a lifeline to touch somebody's heart with this, to make a point. And the point you're really trying to make is valid, but I feel like it's a hypothetical scenario. I could be, you could stretch, because that is a bit of a reach, but I feel like that scenario is something that you would just have it so a lot of people who, you know, disagree with you would, and naysayers would be like, you know, he's making some points, you know what I'm saying? It's the same sympathy card trans people use, you know, I can't get a job, I was so hard out here, I just had to escort over with me, because I've been telling them bitches all the time, honey, you can sell plasma, you can, you know what I'm saying, lashes, okay, online business, you know what I'm saying, do work from home, you know, it's so much more, even if you, you know, it's so much more you could do. You don't have to do that anymore. And people just like, it's survival work. But it's like, no, bitch, it's the work you want to do. Because I've never, you know, when you go on air rolls, make a burst, skip the games, posting on the motherfucking ads, that's because you want to. Don't try to blame that on your transness, like as if now you so. Because it's certain people that now, you know, they have jobs and people have given them opportunities. So, you know, let's not... Girl, what the fuck is going on? Let's not have our oppression and live in it. When you start being a shit too long, it stops stinking. So let's rise up from that. And let's just, you know, I mean, the good news is that what we can say is, you know, none of his kids are transitioning. We're not gonna, hold on. Okay, we're not gonna act like transitioning is a bad thing, but I'm just saying, like, if that's, you know, your concern, and your children are transitioning, all of them are straight and safe and cisgender. So, I mean, this really been no need for this conversation. It's getting hot, but I really don't. I'm pretty sure your fans forgot about you anyway, and half of them don't give a fuck. So. Yeah, I just wanted to kind of just bring that in and really talk about like this. And I did this strategically, Strawberry Space, to have all them black men, because this is a spectrum and the different dynamics of what a black, because listen, let me tell you something, whether you believe it or not, let me give you a little secret. Y'all sprinkle bitches can act like as if y'all don't need a man all y'all want. When a black man talks, y'all listen. Whether y'all agree with him or not, Kevin Samuels was a perfect example. So don't act like when these people go on these podcasts and they be talking to you, just, oh, whatever. But listen, when a black man says something, someone's listening, whether you are for or opposing. So they do have some type of power. You know what I'm saying? They do have some type of influence, and they are on a platform, and their voices will be heard. They will be stitched and reshared, and you know, they will get some type of support. So just like with the whole what's the one that I did the last time with the football player, Jett Henderson's brother. We're on the Cam Newton show. Had that been a trans woman or a trans man, it would have just But since that was a black man, and it was a cisgender and straight, might I add, you gotta have all three in components. And everyone's like, oh, ooh, let's gather around because this is important. And now it was been important. It's not the message, it's the messenger. Now it's someone in your community who you value. You get it? So, yeah, I might do like one more of these little lives, child, but. Yeah, I thought I'd get y'all something today. I don't feel like putting no jury on, so it's just like, it is what it is. But y'all know, I don't really go out like this, but I just, you know, thought of so many voiceovers, you know, y'all would just get tired of that. Y'all just, I have to kick y'all two or three of my face every now and again. But yeah, Strawberry Space, I just want y'all to think about that. And I want you to assist in a minute, one of the allies of the channel. I want y'all to think about how your behavior and characteristics affects the next, because I'm directly affected by that as somebody who is like a main target to what they feel and believe they can share with you based upon how you set the tone. They can't bring plastic silverware if the table is already set with metal forks. You have to kind of like be the introduction to let them know, like, hey, it's okay. This is a judgment-free zone. You know, this is a safe space. And if not, I mean, that's on you. Because whether he confides in you or not, he's still gonna come fuck us. It's just whether he gonna come and tell you. So whether, you know, the nigga is down low or not, it's just like, or I don't wanna say down low, whether the nigga is trans-attracted or not, and bringing awareness to like wearing Brady pansexuality. It's like, it's not just straight and gay. We have like trans attracted, bisexual, you know, we have some demisexual, two-spirit. It's so much stuff you could look up and learn and self-identify with. And I just hate when they be like, oh, I'm a dinosaur. Prove me wrong. It's just like, we're not. You know, going in that direction with it. But yeah, Strawberry Space. So I just hope none of this like offended nobody, you know, or really kind of rubbed nobody the wrong way. Y'all keep watching my shit. I'm so happy that I'm like getting comments, subscribers, thumbs up, views. And I just, you know, I love to be able to be a advocate. And this is my awareness. And this is like a place where I can really show, you know, my intelligence and my voice and my perspective a lot of things, because I've been, you know, told to be quiet. And there's been a lot of doors shut, you know, because of how I think and what I do and how I perceive myself and what I identify with and who I am. So tune in next time, Strawberry Space, because I'm talking about Fancy. She went on a podcast and said she wanted to get fucked by a trans. Oh, I'm gonna talk about it. Y'all know I give you all the tea in the tea sector of the LGBT community. Okay, I don't drink the lemon and OG, I drink the tea, child. And anything trans, I'm gonna talk about it. So I'm gonna jacket back on. Enjoy the rest of my day. It's Sunday, child. I'm gonna gonna see if I could watch a little bit of The Mint and Jocelyn Cabaret and Blueface and all that shit and the baddies. And I'll talk to y'all later, Strawberry Space. Bye.